Sangsar sindhu tarane hidayam yadisat Sankirtanamritarase ramate manushe Premam budhau viharane yadichitabhitte Chaitanya chanda charane kurutanuragam Chaitanya chanda charane kurutanuragam Na Chaitanyat Krishnat Jagati Paratattva Paramiho Sisila Bhakti Siddhanto Saraswati Goswami Pahupacho Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I mean Gaurangadev, started Sankirtan Jagyagni, enlightened Sankirtan Jagyagni in Seva Sangan. Still today a fire is going on by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by Srila Prabhupada, by Keshav Goswami Maharaj, by Sridhar Goswami, on and on. That fire is still there. And Srila Saraswati Thakur told, those who can sacrifice their life for the actual cause of Sankirtan Yajna, only they are Gauriya devotees. Only they can be called Gauriya. So, Prabhupada told, if we are ready to sacrifice our life for the actual cause of Sankirtan Yajna, then we can identify ourselves as Gauriya, otherwise not. Yesterday I told you that if you are not established totally in Guru Tattva, I mean if there is no 100% submission, then you have no right to speak the Absolute Truth. I mean you cannot get power to speak about that Absolute Truth. You can feel weakness. 100% submission means you will have to depend upon Krishna anyhow, all the time. 100% you will have to believe in Krishna. What Krishna can do is approved. Personal effort, personal whimsical attitude do not allow 100% submission. If it is certainly 100% submission is there, only then and then you can get the power to speak about the Absolute Truth. Otherwise, not. In Purushottam Dham, at the appearance day of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, I told that Prabhupada speaking, to satisfy audience, to satisfy public, I mean to seek the satisfaction of public and to seek the satisfaction of Krishna is not the same. To seek the satisfaction of common people and to seek the total satisfaction of Krishna, not the same. Those who are dedicated soul, those who are Gauriya, actual Gauriya, those who are, their life is totally dedicated for the actual cause of Sankirtan and Yajna. Actually, their motive is to satisfy Krishna, Krishna Chaitanya. They always try to satisfy Sankirtanaik Pita Gauranga Mahaprabhu. They have no other objective, no other desire at all. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told, if the whole world going to leave me, if the whole world going to leave me, and those who are coming to me as disciple, if one by one they leave me all, still I am not afraid. I like to speak about that Absolute Truth, same way, same tone. I don't care. standing under the lotus feet of my Guru Padma Paramahansa Sisla Gaurgishadas Bhavai Maharaj. We Gauriyas, we all should have that kind of resolution, like Prabhupada, like son, like father. If you cannot have that kind of resolution, then it is quite impossible to satisfy Sankirtan Pita Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. How you can satisfy? The only way in this Kalika to satisfy Krishna, Krishna Chaitanya, by Sankirtan mode. Saddha sadhan tattva jekichu shagal nam sankirtane paive sak. Everything is available by Sankirtan. And Prabhupada Saraswati was speaking, there is big danger. Why? If there is 100% submission, they cannot be in danger. Ah, right. But for all other people, those who are not developing that kind of submission, for them what happens? Because it is not, all people cannot prove 100% submission at the time of Diksha. I told you, that's why Diksha is a long procedure through which you can go on practicing, servicing Guru and Vaishnava under the guidance of Gurudev. Ultimately, when you are elevated, you can prove that your 100% submission is approved. Satisfied. Then you can get the cream, not before that. Srila Prabhupada Saraswati Pad, really, he is crying for us. He is speaking, Kalaha Kalir Valinaha Indiya Vairi Varga Bhakti Pad Iha Kantaka Koti Ruddha Ha Ha Ka Jami Bikalaha Kimaham Karomi Chaitanya Chanda Yudhina Adhyam Kripam Karoshi. If see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not going to bless us, give us, karuna, then it's quite impossible. Because this is specially Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga is the source of all evils. Kali Yuga is the source of unnecessary fighting. No reason started fighting. What reason? Very small point, very small, there is a side fight. This is the Kalikal is very, very dangerous. So, it's very typical point in this Kalikal, how to avoid all these things and to reach up to the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a vital point. Kalikal is very dangerous. But asti eka mahan gunaha kittanad eva krishnasya mukta sangha param bhajet. Kali is a source of all evils, I know. There is one vital and nice quality, excellent quality that we are having in this Kali Yuga, we can get. What is that? Only by Sankirtan you can get success. Actually, this is a very vital point. Only Sankirtan. But through Sankirtan you can do everything. Because all other way is very dangerous. Kalikal, nothing, no purity there. You cannot find purity. And without purity you cannot, do Harinam Sankirtan properly. Internal purity and external purity both. You have to maintain all the time. Now, we are discussing, we have one point that Dham is more merciful, and one point I like to discuss, tomorrow, but still I'd like to touch it. Bhagavan Sri Krishna is very merciful, we know. But those who are realized soul, for them, Krishna Kripa is available. Not for any common people. But this Gauranga Nityananda Nam is very, very, delicate and very, merciful. Ha Gaur, Ha Nita, if you shout, instant if there is no aparadha, if you have not done any aparadha, Nam Prabhu, unto the lotus, Nam Prabhu, Vaishnava, anything, then instant tears can come. naam loite prem hai bahyostu dhar. So we are very lucky that we are going to get this chance. Gaur Nityananda. Not only that, when you are going to start Harinam, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, every day first you will have to chant Panchatattva. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaur. You can beg for pardon, then you can start. Remember Haridas Thakur, Nityananda, Guru Varga, then you can start Sankirtan. Nirvignam kuru tam male. He male. Male min mala. Try to bless me so that I can do my Harinam without any flaw, you know, flaw or any problem. Every day morning you will have to remember all Guru Vaishnava, Panchatattva, Rupa Raghunath, Jai Rupa Sanatana Bhattara, so that whole day you can do Sankirtan very powerfully without any disturbance, because Kalikal. You can try my point. What I am speaking, you can try from tomorrow. Nishingadev, Prabhupada, Gurudev, all Guru Varga, Rupa Raghunath, you can see all problem automatically finish. You can have the chance to do Harinam Sankirtan very nicely. That is the main point. Now another point which Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving instruction, Dham Parikram. So Dham Parikram is very, very sensitive thing. All common people can get kripa, you know, sukriti, power, you know. And ultimately, actually, in devotional line, if you start, Adau Guru Padasa is quite natural. But main point is that Kaloho Kalir Valila Valina Indio Vairi Varga Bhaktipatiha Kantaka Koti Ruddho. In each and every step you are going to put your leg on throne. Throne, you know, Kanta. Big problem. Every Kanta means problem. In the way of your bhajan, you are getting this problem. Kanta. Throne. So Prabhupadananda Saraswati very young, he's kind actually. Kalaha Kalir Varina India Vaidhi Varga Bhaktivat Iha Kantaka Koti Ruddha. There are crores of throne there. If you have that kind of endeavor, that kind of power, that kind of, you know, bravery, then you can go ahead. Crossing all problem. How? Like Dhruva Maharaj? I can go back to this point from Bhagavatam. Last moment, you know, Biman, plane coming, I mean chariot coming to take Dhruva Maharaj. And those Vishnudu think, Dhruva Maharaj, come on, here, your seat is there. And Dhruva Maharaj, in front of Dhruva Maharaj, one very, very dangerous, you know, face. Demon coming in front. Hey, where are you going? The one is asking, who are you? Who are you, man? I am Mrityu. You know, not Jomaraj, the sending. I mean, nobody can cross me. First you will have to meet me. The one actually, okay, come on. Plane is there, I mean Biman is there. Dhumar put his leg on his head, crashed down and get into the plane. So if you are Gauriya Vaishnava, if you are ready to identify yourself as Gauriya Vaishnava, you should have that kind of power. You should develop that kind of power. We are at all not going to be defeated by any problem. That's why Prabhupada is repeatedly in front of all devotees requesting. Prabhupada is requesting, O devotees. O devotees, try to be satisfied in any situation you are put into. In any situation you are put into, according to your past deeds, activities, try to treat as the blessing of Krishna. Don't express any kind of dissatisfaction. Well, I am poor, I have no money, I have no fan is there, no AC is there, how I can speak Harikatha and listen. Come on, all of our Guru Varga, you know, 60,000 received there in, Naimi Chetra and Sukhdev Goswami there, 88,000. They are listening without mic, nothing, no facility, they are hot sound, they are hearing Harikatha so nicely. It is nectar. To get nectar, you will have to sacrifice everything. Not that you can get all facilities, then you can sit for Harikatha and sing that, then you are not at all qualified. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can throw you out. Go. Like Sivas, mother-in-law. Not mother. Why you are speaking wrong? Catch the, Sivas and go down. Go outside. What do you think? You have the right to see the Sankirtan Yagya of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rasa. Go out straight. Don't allow. This way, to get maturity, we are trying day and night. Dham Parikram is also very nice. But the actual procedure you cannot follow. During the parikram, you cannot use sandal, chappal. During parikram, you cannot use vehicle. During parikrama, you cannot use any kind of facility. But you cannot do. Anyway, you are doing it is also very nice. So you'll have to do parikram with full power, guru kipa. So yesterday I was discussing about dham parikram. So dham parikram, actually I was in hurry. I Shankarpur, I told you one point here. Some point I miss, I remember after while I'm going. Shankarpur is a place where Shankaracharya, when he is, in the way of his victory, defeat, coming here in Shankarpur, there Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came in dream. Gauranga, hey Shankar, you are my servant, I know. But this is not the place where you can preach Mayavad Siddhanta. This is not the place. Though I know it was by my instruction you started preaching Mayavad. I know. It was my instruction to preach Mayavad. You have done well. But this is my own home. Here is the place of Shuddha Bhakti. So you have no right to stay here. Please take, go from here. That place where Shankaracharya came and got keeper of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that place is Shankarpur. Also, when I crossed the river and going to, Gadrumdeep, and Godrum, while Godrum, the Nishingapalli, Subarnavihar, Nishingapalli, then come back to Varanasi, then off-site, at that side, cross of river, I told you, say, Naimish Chetra, 703 Adi, some Rishi, they are dancing and singing about the glories of Gauranga. Shankar Bhagavan took the opportunity there, I told you. But I forgot to speak another thing, in that Madhyadvip, there also one very, very important spot, some spot. Like you see, Pushkar Tirtha. One Brahmin was there, Dibodas. Long ago, not today. He was very, willing to go to take darshan of Pushkar Tirtha and take bath there. Very nice devotee. Dedicated soul actually. He is craving, always trying to go up to Pushkar Tirtha to take bath there. Glories of Pushkar Tirtha is big. But he is very old man and poor, he cannot take trouble to go up to that point. So night time in dream, Pushkar, he got information that here, near his house, there is Pushkar Tirtha. There is Pushkar Tirtha there, very near. Why you are going to take trouble? You can take bath here. Here all Tirtha there. Pushkar Tirtha is very, here. Then morning time, Pushkar, he got the darshan of Pushkar Tirtha. And then, you see, he was very satisfied. This is the spot, Madhyadvip. And Madhyadvip also, you can get this, Alokananda stream going there, straight. Then after that, I told you, Brahman Pukur, that is called Pushkar Tirtha, that place, very nice. After that, I told you, you cross the river and you are going to, at present, but that time river was different, way. First, we take darshan of Porama, but there as per Bhaktivinoda Thakur it is in, anyway. So, Porama Thala, I told you, Yogamaya, Pauramaya, Yogamaya, and Vridhasiv, knowledgeable, very, very, full of bhakti. Knowledge mean? Knowledge of bhakti. Bhakti. Because dry knowledge, no use, useless dry knowledge. So, actually, that after taking the, you have to pray. I told you same thing. Kulo Devi, Yogamaya, Morekipa Kori, Avaron, Sangbari Betome Vishadori. Suneche Agam Bede, Mahima Tomar, Krishna Bimukhe Dori, Karal, Sangsar, Krishna Sanmukho Jar, Bhagya Kame Hoy, Tare Mukti Diya Karo, Ashoko Hoy. What does it mean? Kulo Devi Yogamaya, here in my line, disciplic succession, Kulo Devi. Kul means, sometimes we say in our destiny, in our, So, this inner meaning is that you are very near a dear one. We respect you very much. So, we are craving, we are praying in front of you, Mataji. Kulodevi Jogmaya More Kipa Kori, you must bless me. Avaran Sangbaribe Tumi Vishodori. There is one covering of Maya. Why people cannot see that absolute truth? Why people cannot see that absolute truth? What's the reason? There is one screen. Kunti Devi also praying same thing. Nato natto dharo yatha. Like drama, people sometimes playing drama. He is just your friend. But when he is acting, where, who is he? He cannot identify. He is in, he cannot understand. He is painting there. So this way, Kunti Devi is doing natu natu dharu yatha. Like puppet on a chain, a puppet on a string, nobody can see. You can see only two puppets fighting. Who? Making them dancing? You cannot see. Kunti Devi is speaking like that. So this way, you see, why people cannot see that absolute truth? What is the reason behind it? Because there is one screen of Maya. If the screen is unveiled, straightway you can see that transcendental world. But it is not possible for you. Until and unless Mataji is going to give you full kippa, unveil the screen, till then your darshan, your sight is not pure. Your darshan is not contaminated by Maya somehow. You can go to Vrindavan, those who are elevated soul, they are saying that it is full Vrindavan. Still, in this material world, in Vrindavan you can see everything, but at the same time you can find some people there, this, that, contaminated. Some contaminated, but their darshan is very pure, they can find those who are pure devotee. But in Golok, there is no contamination. In prapancha, in this material world, you can see. So this way, you see, Yogamaya, I mean Mahamaya can unveil, then Yogamaya can give you opportunity to get in connection with the Supreme Lord. And we heard from Vedanta, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, that those who are averse, those who don't like to do bhajan, for them you play a magic spell. So in their heart, they don't feel it necessary to do Krishna bhajan. So you make them averse, you put them in material samsara, and they are getting pain and pain again and again. And we heard that when somebody willing to do bhajan, taking shelter of Guru Vaishnava, please do me kipa. Vaishnavir karuna. If we are enjoying, then what happens? When Vaishnava praying for me in front of Krishna, then Krishna can give response. On behalf of me, if on pure Vaishnava praying in front of Krishna, then Krishna, because you have no connection with Krishna, it's a big problem. So actually in Gita also it is written, why those people, they are hypnotized by Maya? Why? Because they are in Maya. There is Maya, that's why they cannot see me. They are hypnotized, they are in Maya. That's why they cannot see me. So Kuladevi Jagma is vital point. Kuladevi Jagma, if going to give you kipa, then you can unveil screen, then you can go ahead. Otherwise, big problem. So you will have to do kirtan there. After that, you will have to go to aparadha banjan pa, I mean, there, Devananda Pandit place, at present Devananda Gauriamat. That's what you can take darshan of Barahadev. Barahadev there. Then after, this is a system at present. At present this is the system. Otherwise you have to go that way. It is written there. Then after that you will have to come. Brahman Pugur, from there you have to go. You know, now at present you can find. Oh, we can go this way also. I can this. You can do. You can follow book. Actually, you can find Gauranga Setu there. One bridge is there, Gauranga over Ganga. One Gauranga Setu is there, bridge is there. That just down Gauranga Setu, there is panchaveni, very nice tirtha. Five different rivers, Alakananda, Bhagirathi, Ganga, Bhagavati, they all confluence, and Saraswati, five rivers. It is written in scripture, Bhaktivinoda speaking, it is the topmost place to get purified. If you like to purify yourself, there's topmost place in whole universe. It is written there. Topmost place. If you can get bath there, hundreds of times if you go to Ganga Sagar here, there, take bath, it is not equal to that. Panchaveni. Just down that bridge, right hand side. Bridge starting from here, bridge end, Koladwip touch, there. Just go down that place. If you go north side, I mean river this side, there is one vacant place, vacant ground. This is called Kurukshetra. Kurukshetra is there. I mean all pilgrimage there, all, everything. Kurukshetra. Very pure place. Those demigods, they took this opportunity to come here and do Sankirtan very loudly. Those demigods there. They are in full group, they came and doing Sankirtan very nice. Gauranga, Gauranga, very nice the Sankirtan. Loudly, that's a Uchchohas. Uchchohas, yes, it is written there. Because loudly they are singing about Gauranga. It's a very nice place there. This way you are getting all, you know, tirtha there, very nice place, very nice. So actually Koladwip, there you can find some land is high, heaps of mud there. It is written, it is called actually Govardhan, high hill. In Koladwip, Govardhan is there. Koladwip, I already told, it is called Bahulavan, I told you. Very nice place. They actually heaps of mud, you can find high land. This is actually Govardhan, Giriraj. So at the same time, you are getting facility. Panchaveni, Kurukshetra here. All, every spot, I cannot describe. Impossible. It is written that all the pilgrimage in this, India or in whole universe, is everything there. But we have to trace out very, very, all tirtha. So there in Koladwip, I told you, one Brahman was there, who is crying whole day and night to take darshan of his Ishtadev, Barahadev, Shyam Baraha. Whole day and night he is worshipping there, Koladwip. Day and night he is worshipping, oh Prabhu, oh Prabhu. One day that Barahadev came, big cloud, like dense cloud, black. Barahadev appearing, giving him blessing. He is very much satisfied, worshipping him. Koladwip is very important place, one point. And another point is there, I forget to speak you right now, I should speak, that a Brahma, together with Brahma, all demigods, they are doing crores of jagya, different kind of jagya in Panchaveni. That's the spot where I told if you can take bath, it's very important. Crores of jagya. Those demigods, together with Brahma, Indra, they have been doing. Maybe still they are doing. We cannot see. We are blind. We cannot see. They are doing jagya. It's very pure place. And for jagya, you know it, that Barahadev, in third canto, we know, when Barahadev, shrugging his head, then some, this room, this hair, body hair, fall down from there, Kash and Kush. Kash and Kush, you know, you give Kushasan to Maharaj. Kushasan. Kushasan is very pure. You cannot give under leg. You can sit for Jagya, for is most pure. Kushasan is most pure. More than Kushasan, we cannot expect. Kushasan, stop. So, under leg you cannot give. You can give another asana. So, Kushasan, Kushavarta, one place in South India, when at the bank of Narmada, the kingdom of Manu Maharaj. I am not going to discuss this point, but vital point, Barahadev is the main, source of Jagya. Without Barahadev, who is going to get Kush and Kash? Without Kush and Kash, Yagya is impossible. So now onward you are getting this facility. It's very, very nice place. If you have previous aparadha, we can cut all aparadha very nicely. Go and cry there in Koladwip. Roll down on the ground and take bath in Ganga, O Prabhu, do Sankirtan. Instantly you can get mercy. You can give free of any kind of, aparadha. Aparadha is a vital thing for why we cannot go ahead in bhajan. Aparadha, that is due to aparadha. Why we cannot go? Many foreign devotees coming in front of Guru Maharaj, in front of Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, we have seen. They are crying. Even they asking me, Maharaj, why you are not going, we are getting kripa, but still we cannot go ahead in Harinam. Hariram Yoga can touch, cannot touch. I say, come on man, there is different kind of aparadha touching your heart. Why? Like Nama aparadha, Dhamma aparadha, you know, Vaishnava aparadha, different kind of aparadha, obstruction. Those are the obstruction for your pure bhajan. So anyhow you have to cut this point very cleverly. So it is written that Jejan Krishna Bhajesh Yahai Bharo Chatur, it is written there. Those who are going to do Krishna Bhajan, they are very clever, very clever. And if some material person coming in front of me, it is written, we cannot see any material people, you should not talk, do as take association with material people, but what to do? I am in society. Where I can go? If some material people comes in, Maharaj, I can say, hey, go away. I cannot speak this way. Somehow, cleverly, like Gaurakishwarbha, I can give one example. In front of Gaurakishwarbha Ji Maharaj, one material person comes. Gaurakishwarbha Ji Maharaj, in front of Gaurakishwarbha Ji Maharaj, and Gaurakishwarbha always cannot say that, go away from me. Not that, it's, no, it looks bad. Gaurakishwarbha Ji Maharaj, he is talking with Gaurakishwarbha Ji. He is asking, at present, what is the land price there, where you are staying there? What is the land price? And the rice kg, how much price? He is asking this much. This way, try to, you know, pass away. Dodging. In football, some kind of dodging is needed. You have to pass and go for goal. This way, those who are doing bhajan, they must be very clever. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu showing everything to his bhajan procedure. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saying, Sabhaktibhyo sudhyam nija bhajana mudram padisan sa chaitanya kingime punarapidi swarya swatipadam. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can again show the lotus feet. He is showing everything. All the secrecies of bhajan, you can get all information. But you will have to approach a bona fide Sadguru. He can only guide you, otherwise you are blind, you cannot see. You can go to market and buy Chaitanya Charitamrita, Chaitanya Bhagavata and recite. You can go to market and buy Bhagavatam, Upanishad, Vedanta. Who is going to stop you? You can do it. But how you can get the cream? How you can get the cream? Like I can give you one example, you see. You like to get honey. Huh? For honey, you are bound to depend upon honeybees. If you collect so many flower for garden and grinder, you put in grinder and paste, you cannot get one drop of honey. You can get? There is big garden. You can get different kind of flower. In flower, you heard that honey is there. You can put in grinder and you can paste and get one drop of honey. Can you get? You cannot get. It is not possible. You have grinder, everything. You have power. For honey, you will have to depend upon honeybees. No other way. Nana sasto vichara naiko nipuno saddharma sangsthapako lokanam hitakarino tibubane manyo saranyakaru. I told you. Those Goswamis, those are Guru Varga, specially the seventh Goswami, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, giving very, very nice cream malai for us. You need not play head. Your brain is very small. Your power is very, you know, low power. So you have to depend upon Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you have to Prabhupada, Guru Varga. Then you can get cream. You cannot sit in chair for 2 hours at least. Asanjay. First you will have to, you know, conquer asan. There is so many things. Asanjay. Who can sit in one asan for long period? Who? at a stretch, 8 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours, one big, big sadhu, they can sit, one asana. Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta, Haridas Thakur, in one asana, sitting and doing. They feel comfortable all the time. If everything, all your sense organ under your own control, then no problem. Main problem is sense organ. So, you see, you will have to depend upon honeybees. Honeybees means those Guru Varga. You have no time to go through all Purans and Ved, Vedanta. You have no power to get the cream. It is an instruction on them by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They have their power, so they can do it. They are already done. So this is the main problem. So you have to avoid all problems, then go ahead. Otherwise, if there is aparadha, then you can. I told you, you will have to recite Bindadivistakam every day, specially Dadasi night time. Every Dadasi nice time, if you recite Bindadevi Stotram, then Krishna is bound to excuse you. You can avoid. Or two chapters of Gita you will have to recite daily. Two chapters. Whichever if is feasible for you can do. So you can get excuse. This way you see, now this place is so important, Koladwip, and after that you say, take the darshan of panchaveni, Kurukshetra, Uchahat, and then from there, now onward you are going towards Sumudragar. I told you yesterday, Sumudragar is Kumudvan. Still today, if you go to Kumudvan, you can get same thing. Sumudra, Ganga Sagar is there, Kapil Muni. So Ganga Sagar. Sagar came here to meet with Ganga to get the facility to look, this Gaurdham, to get Kripa. So, Makar Sankranti day, still today, if you take bath in this Ganga, you can think, where is Sumudra? I cannot see Sumudra. But if you take bath here, 100 times more you are going to get benefit than this Ganga Sagar. Still today you can watch at the Makar Sankranti, Paush Mas, all people coming to take bath. You not watching? Thousands of people coming. Come on, man. Thousands of people they are coming to take bath here. Ganga. So I know how their Bhimsen was, captivated. After that, set free. Krishna give kripa. Then again I come back to Champahati, Champahati, that Dijobaninath place, Dijobaninath, one is the eternal parshad of Gauranga. He installed Gaur Gadar Vigraha. God there, he is worshipping with Baba, very nice. So that is very important place for us, Gaur Gadar Vigraha. And I told you, Jayadev Goswami also, first in Kendavillu Gram. After they received here, near Ballal, Ballal Sen, here I can discuss after. Here, Jayadev Goswami's Bhajan Kutir. After he shifted to Champahati, how this Champahati name, we got, this I already told you, Champak Puspa, very nice. And that is called, I told you, is Kadirvan, I told you. And from there, now you have to go inside there towards Vidyanagar. Towards Vidyanagar, you are starting, but not, it is long distance. But there, you can find one place there, Ratupur, there you can find the Radha Kundu Sample. Up to this point, I discussed yesterday. Ratupur. A very nice place, Ratipur, very nice decorated place, very nice. So, you see, that place is, Radhakund, Samkund, a very nice place. From there, you see, you will have to go again onward. Then you can get the chance to meet Vidyanagar. Vidyanagar, one nice place there. Actually, Vidyanagar is the topmost place in this whole universe where any kind of vidya, education, is available here. Any big, big writer like Valmiki Muni or anybody, Vyasa, they all got power from here. Vidyanagar is the main source of all vidya. Vidya, all vidya available. Sarvam Bhattacharya, actually, he is a Brihaspati, guru of all demigods. Brihaspati he is. So this Brihaspati, you know, his guru, very learned, you know. He took birth here in this Vidyanagar as Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Actually, his name was Vasudev. Atato Sarvabhauma is his title he got. From whole India, everybody giving his title. He is Sarvabhauma, means he is dominating the whole educated society. So powerful, educated man. So this way, Brihaspati Shakshat came to get this Vidya Rasa. To get this Vidya Rasa here in this Vidyanagar. So Vidyanagar, Gauranga Mahaprabhu also having using this, you know. So everybody. So Maheshwar Visharad is the father of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Sarvabhauma Maheshwar. And Maheshwar Visharad and Jagannath Mishra, two friends. They used to read together. He is reading in this place, he is also reading in same school of philosophy. They are reading. That's why they are actually called, that's why it is called, you see, you know, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, his father and brother also there, Maheshwar Visharad, they are all big, big educated. He is feeling drowsy. So, you see, this is the place where if you try to get any kind of education, if you try to get any kind of education, if you are, then you can try. 100% if you try from heart, if you can get kripa, that vidya can come inside you. That is the main place, you see. And there, actually, our Prabhupada, he is also installing one, you know, set one mat, Vidyanagar mat, very small mat, Vidyanagar, that place, and you can get darshan of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's, you know, native place, I mean, where he took birth. That place is also there, Madan Gopala, the deity is there, you can take darshan. You've been there? No? So anyway, you cannot remember. So there is very nice place. From there, you will have to start again for, you know, Jannudip. Jannudip. You will have to come. Jannudip. So Jannudip, actually it is called, you know, ki, Badravan. Jannudip is very important place. Jannudip, actually, Jannumuni, you know, Jannumuni, very powerful muni. He was doing bhajan there. And somehow, when Bhagirath Maharaj, in the destiny of Dilip Raja, he took the responsibility to bring Ganga by his own strategy and finances. He satisfied, you know, Gangaji. Still Gangaji is speaking, how I can land? Who can resist my power? Nobody there. Then he praying again, he starting bhajan for Shankar Bhagavan, aradhana. Then Shankar Bhagavan appear, what you need, son? Bala Prabhu, you are father of whole society, you will have to do one, give one facility. What facility? Ganga want to come here, Ganga Mata, but who is going to catch his force? Nobody can catch. Because if Ganga directly coming here, then directly it can go to Patal. Down and down. Who is there to catch a source, force of power, I mean water? Then Shankar Bhagavan ready to look here, I can. Then Ganga coming down in this material world, then Shankar Bhagavan in his, in his method here, the Ganga circulating here. Then he is requesting Shankar, Shankar Bhagavan, where is Ganga? Where is Ganga? Where is Ganga? Well, I can let it out, then give place, and from there Ganga again coming down. Still, one Ganga is Alokananda, Alokananda, Bhagirathi, Alokananda, you know. And, you know, Mandakini and Bhogavati. Bhogavati means which is down. That flow of Ganga which is just down, Akase Mandakini. When he is falling down in space, it's Mandakini. There you can go. Mandakini you can get. In Navy you cannot go, I think. It's a dangerous place there. Badinarayan. Kedarnarayan. Not in Badinarayan. And Alokananda there. So you see, Mandakini, I've been there. Very tough place, Mandakini. So you'll have to take bath in Mandakini. Ice melted water, Mandakini, then I worship, you know, Kedarnath there, said by Panchapandav there. There is so big queue, 2-3 kilometers. I don't know why, what is the magic spell of Shankar Bhagavan. I took water and some flower and straightway entered into temple. No policeman, no military speaking anything. Maybe it is the mercy of Shankar. I go and worship and go out. So nice place there. Mandakini. And Alokananda you can find there in Badinarayan, that place. Sasada. There also one pro Saraswati coming, where Vyasagupa there. And up Vyasagupa you can see Saraswati coming, Vyasagupa here. There Saraswati again coming and meeting with the flow, main flow of Alokananda. See, this is Alokananda. So this way, you know, big problem. And then, three part, and Ganga going here and there somehow, zigzag way, sometime down, Saraswati also. You cannot find Saraswati totally. We saw Saraswati directly. After the Saraswati, where? Gone here, after the Saraswati, underground, again going there. Saraswati, the track of Saraswati is very, you know, zigzag. You cannot find Saraswati. Some flow going there, after in Rajasthan, some place, again, you cannot vanish Saraswati. This way, again Saraswati coming here. Saraswati also, we can find Saraswati here in this spot. This Gaurdham. Saraswati, I told you, in Panchaveni, everything you can get. Even here also. Bhakti Maharaj saying, this is the flow, small river, is flow. Some flow, stream of Saraswati is also there. That backside, small river. This way, so now point is that Ganga Devi took decision to stay here for some days. I told you yesterday. Ganganagar. Bhagirath talking, mother, what happens, why you are not... My son, you see, Gaur Purnim coming very shortly. I cannot leave this opportunity very shortly. Falguni Purnima. Gauranga, my Prabhu, going to, it's the appearance day of, and this is Navadvipa Dham, you don't know. So I cannot go right now. You will have to wait. When you can go? After Gaur Purnim. I can do some bhajan here, worship my Prabhu, then I can again go with you. I promise you I can go. Then again started going, because Ganga supposed to go that way. Why Ganga coming this way? Nobody knows. To touch Navadvip Dham. To touch mainly Ganga is strange. Ganga, how Ganga coming here? Ganga is the flow, main stream is different. Everybody laughing, how Ganga coming here? They don't know. Just opposite. Ganga is supposed to go there. Darbhanga, Patna, they say. How Ganga coming here? Opposite way. Just to get the facility of Gaur Kripa. Why? Because Ganga was very sorry. Because Krishna giving full facility to Jamuna. Jamuna is very lucky. Ganga crying. Jamuna is very lucky. I am not lucky. Prabhu, what to do? I can make you lucky again. I am coming. No problem. You wait. Then promise Prabhu. Then Prabhu coming here in, you know, Navadvipa, Gauranga whole day and night dancing and, you know, swimming, everything he is doing here. Whole day and night. Even more than Krishna doing in Jamuna. Krishna not playing in Jamuna so much. But Gauranga whole day and night. In Bollywood. So giving facility. So this Ganga actually, this Ganga, which is in touch of Gauranga, this Ganga can give you prema. Otherwise not. There was big fighting in Delhi about the glories of Ganga and Jamuna took place. Nobody can settle down this problem. Then Jiva Goswami was called. Jiva said, I cannot go there because I cannot stay anywhere. Night. Okay, we can arrange so that you can go and come back very quickly. You need not stay there. So Grantang Road was very special road arrangement was done by King Batsa. Special chariot. Very, very high powerful horse. Very, very powerful. Going. And there Jiva Goswami Pada was his lotus feet, sit in Sabha, giving judgment. The though Ganga is coming from the lotus, you know, feet of Krishna, but still the glories of Jamuna is more because Jamuna is Patrani. And Jamuna can give prema. Jamuna can give prema, but still, I would say, Jamuna, when in touch of this Navadvip Dhama, has some special power to give you prema. Here, Premtali. Premtali, you know, now in Bangladesh, for Nityananda Prabhu, prema was there, waiting. Then, Padda asking, how I can know who is Narottam? Then Prabhu told, who is going to take bath, and then you can feel, you know, flowing, your heart dancing, then you can understand, this is Narottam. Premtali, still one, that place is there. Prema is deposited there. So you know, so this is Siddhanta is very nice. When Ganga in touch of Gauranga is you know, then you can get there. So now point is that some from so Radha Kunda Sam Kunda you are going towards Vidyanagar. Vidyanagar you get this facility to get the darshan of Sarvamataji's house. This is a very nice place. Very nice place, tranquil place you can go. Still today you can feel. If you like to learn anything, if you can get teacher, you can learn. But your dedication should be perfect. From there we are going to Jannudip. Jannudip. Now just we leave Ritudip. Just now I leave Ritudip. After that, you know, Jannudip. Jannudip is Bhadravan, I told you. And here actually, Janu Muni used to do bhajan. But somehow when Bhagirathi, I mean mainstream of Ganga coming, this way, some stream, and Janu Muni doing bhajan in ashram, and all flood in, all his, you know, panchapatra and everything gone. Janumuni become very angry. Hey, who is there making this disturbance? Oh, Ganga? I drink all Ganga. Total Ganga going inside. You cannot even imagine. It is possible. It's possible. Janumuni drink. Bhagirathi, I mean, now Bhagirath cannot find Ganga. Where is Madha? Where is Madha? Then he finds Janumuni already drink. He is crying. If you cannot give me Ganga Mata, then how I can deliver my, you know, 60,000 of my forefathers. It's very typical. He is crying all day and night. Then Jannamuni began to satisfy. Okay, ja. Then cut this, you know, this place. Jannu, Jang, Thai. Cut and Ganga coming out of this. That is Jannavi. Previously, Jannavi, this name was not there. From Jang, Thai. Is called actually, from this place, actually Ganga again coming out. Then Ganga again with Bhagirath blowing conch. Then going again up to Ganga Sagar there. This way you have the facility to take darshan. Now actually, if you like to point out the spot, is very difficult for you to understand. Because all, you know, changed. There is one small tree, you cannot believe this word. There is all locality here. So, 100% belief should be there. You should concentrate your mind onto this spot. I mean, Leela. From there, actually, you can, again, you can start going. You will have to go on and on. And from Jannudev, you can enter into Hematpur, Mamgachi after. But I know Mamgachi. Mamgachi, no, before the Hematpur or like that, one place is there. And that is very important, that is called Kamban. This is Kamban actually. So in this place, one important thing happens actually. Before that, one place, another place is there, that is Vaikunthapur. Another place, I forget. So many places. Vaikunthapur, they are actually very nice place. It is just Vaikuntha there, same place here. Vaikuntha. Whereas Vaikuntha, Narayan saying, that Vaikuntha here, Vaikuntha. Actually, Jagannath Puri, Jagannath Dev, giving instruction to Ramanujacharya. Ramanuja has been there. Jagannath giving instruction, hey, now you go to Vaikunthapur in Navadvip Dham. There you can get full kripa. I am coming there. After some time. Because Ramanuja, when came, Gauranga Avatar was not there. So, by the instruction of Jagannath, Ramanuja is coming here. And he is crying and doing bhajan nicely. One day Gauranga appear very nicely, giving full blessing to him. Vaikunthapur. But anyway, Sri Lakshmi Devi giving power. That's why his sampradaya Sri actually Ramanujaja sampradaya is his sampradaya. And Chotuswan, I told you, got power. Who? Nimbaditta? Nimbaditta? Here came? And Bilpakur? You forget actually. I told you already. Here. So actually that place there, Ramanujacharya got full power there. Full instruction. And actually, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, you will have to preach about Dasa Bhakti very nicely. Go. After that, where is Hematu? Very nice place. That is very important place. In this place actually, Pancha Pandav, when they were in exile, they happened to come here, in this Kamban. Yudhishthira Maharaj, Bhim, Arjun, Nakul, Sahadev, they all came. Draupadi. Yudhishthira is also there, you can find. One night, Yudhishthira Maharaj in dream is walking, golden complexion. Who are you? I am Gauranga, your friend Krishna. You Krishna? Yes. In this form, I am here permanently. So I am always with you. Panchapandav, Krishna is the friend of Panchapandav. So don't think. Actually, now you are Panchapandav, but when I appear, you have to take bath in Orissa. I mean, Ramananda, Basunanda, sab there, their whole family, Panchapandav, Mahaprabhu already told them, Chaitanya. You are all Panchapanda previously. Now you are coming to me. you see, Ramananda Rai, his brother, they are all Panchapanda actually. So Gauranga speaking, They actually Yudhishthir, I am your actually brother, Nebu Krishna, now in this form. Panchavana. Then blessing. So you will have to go there and take birth. When I am appearing, I am going to come. Then for some days, Yudhishthira Maharaj was very happy to stay there and come, but very nice place. So nice place, you see. Then after that, you see, Kamban, very nice place. Kamban, there is so many places actually, so many places, but you should develop that kind of eyes so that you can watch actually. So many problem of Maya. All the time, those who are doing bhajan, for them Maya always checking them, crossing, beating, trying. So after that, you have the chance, I mean, Kamban there, and actually there is actually, you are entering into Madhudrumdeep. Madhudrumdeep actually adjacent, is just Vaikunthapur, Hematpur, just adjacent actually. So there you see, Sri Ramchandra, Lakshmanji, they all came. When they are in exile, they came here, and Ramchandra is Supreme Lord actually. So knowing that another avatar, I am coming to take birth here again, as gold. They say they are staying here for some time actually, Hunumantala also. Very nice, there is some place, Ramji is staying there. And also, at present you can find nice spot. Like actually you can get Saranga Muradi spot. Who is Saranga Muradi? His name was Saranga. One day, he took decision not to give initiation to anybody. One night, Gauranga giving his, hey, you will have to give instruction. Hey, you have to give initiation. Whom to give initiation? Who is going to obey me? You will have to give initiation. Whom to give initiation? Morning time, you go to take bath. Usually, you go to take bath in Ganga. Whenever you see the first man, you will have to give Diksha to him. First man? Where you meet first man, you will have to give Diksha. He is going to take bath in Ganga. He is taking bath, nobody there. 4 o'clock, who is going to take bath? Then he find one last dead body coming. Dead body coming? Touching it? Then he thought, who told me who is coming to you? I have to give an initiation bath? Dead body is doing Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Stand up. He stand up. Alive. Dead body. He is giving initiation. From then, his name is Saranga Murari. Very nice. His deity is there, you can find. Very nice place. From there, you see, there is so many spots actually. You will have to. And remember it, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada also, near Vrindavan Das Thakur, he made one bhajan kutir where he used to write books. That place is now gone, meaning captured by some material people. Very nice place. Just near Vrindavan Das Thakur. Vrindavan Das Thakur gate here, just opposite. Some place was there, it is just, captured by some material people. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada used to do bhajan there exclusively. And writing something under the guidance of Vrindavan Das Thakur. Srila Saraswati Thakur Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati used to do bhajan also in, Krishnanagar Chariye. Krishnanagar is after crossing Krishnanagar, that place is there. I already told you in Harikatha. That place is, I forget actually. There, No. I always speak, now I forget, I can give you. There also, you to do bhajan there. Bhajan nicely. One Gauranga Vigga was there. Only Gauranga and Shevak is there, Prabhupada holy writing. Prabhupada wrote the Janmadasya Yatya Anvayad, this sloka's total Vaksha, he wrote there. Nobody disturbing, nobody coming, only snake and big jackal all around, nobody there to disturb, and Prabhupada writing there. that plum. Yeah. There, and also here also, Bhajan Kutir was there, nice place. So this way actually, Vrindavan Das Thakur, the son of who? Narayani Devi. Narayani Devi is actually is the, you know, is the niece, not niece, of Sivas Pandit. And when child, as a childhood, actually Gauranga Mahaprabhu Uchishta. So, by chance, you know, Narayani in the childhood got prema, started from. So, from Narayani Devi, Vrindavan Das Thakur took birth. So, Vrindavan Das Thakur used to stay there, do bhajan there very nicely. And Gaur Nityananda deity there used to worship. Because Vrindavan Das Thakur is the last disciple of Nityananda. Last disciple of Nityananda Prabhu used to doing bhajan there, writing, you know, Chaitanya Bhagavatadi there actually. And it's called Mao Gachi. From that name came Mam Gachi. Actually Mao Gachi is speaking there. So Prabhupada tried to re-establish the Seva Vrindavan Das Thakur. Actually it was almost forest. So Prabhupada went there, arranged a seva facility there. Now you can get big temple there, but at that time no facility was there, no water, no nothing. Only bamboo garden all around. Big problem. So from there, actually you will have to come back gradually. When now actually Banda Tukuri, one station there, that time no rail, no train station. So you have to cross rail track and come gradually. From there you will have to come gradually very, but I forget one point. Madhvacharya also got kripa in this Madhyadvip. In this Madhvacharya came here, and Gauranga Mahaprabhu, he got darshan, he was doing bhajan here nicely with full shisha, with his disciple all. He came here, he's doing bhajan here for some time, knowing everything. And Gauranga giving, he could take darshan of Gauranga. Gauranga giving full kripa. Well, Madhya, you preach about the, you know, full faith in deity, vigra seva. These two things you will have to do, vigra and archan, and 100%. Vigra seva can give bhakti. You preach this thing. And in Kalikal, I am going to take birth as Gauranga, this appearance. I am going to accept your sampradaya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing this way, Mahaprabhu promising that I am going to accept your sampradaya, so people can speak the Madhya Gauriya sampradaya. People can speak this way, is Madhya Gauriya sampradaya. So I am going to accept your sampradaya, this Kali Yuga. You try to, two duty I give you. First, Ramanujanja also break Mayavad. Specially, Mahaprabhu speaking, you will have to break Mayavad, crush down Mayavad. It is your duty, I give you. Second, deity, full faith in deity seva. And by deity seva, you can get bhakti, you have to nitta. You have to preach this thing, this two. Then, Madhyacharya got full blessing. Gauranga appear. Then after that he started preaching this. They are very nice, actually, doing well. Then actually after that, so you see, three Acharya, Nimbakacharya gone, here Ramanujacharya, Madhyacharya, all Acharya. Not all Acharya, even Bhaskaracharya also, after all Acharyas, they, even, you know, another Acharya, I forget, I can speak after, you know. So, after that you go on, you know, walking down. After that you can go at the cross of Ganga, near at present, now, at present you get Navadvip hospital. At present. And previously, what was the situation, I don't know. At present, I cross river, I know, that's why I know. From there, you have to enter at least 1 or 2 kilometers from hospital's gate, that side. You know, then north side, northeast, yes. You have to run at least 2 kilometers through village. Then you can get the, you know, bank of Ganga. Very big current is there, then you can get boat there, you can cross river, from there itself you can watch that Rudradeep. From there you can watch Rudradeep, but still you have to cross, because you have to touch Rudradeep. Rudra is a very important place. 11 Rudra, Neel, Lohito, Adi, Rudra, they are dancing there, all their night. Gaur, 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 boom, 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 there. That Rudradeep. Still today you can get their kippa if you have that kind of, you know, mentality. Full kippa. Still today. So that, you know, Rudradeep is there. So you can pray. Neel Rahita or Rudra, you know. You see. And Vishnu Swami used to come there and do bhajan there nicely. You know, you see. So actually there, he is doing bhajan, and after a long time, Gauranga appear in him and doing kippa, full kippa, Vishnu Swami. He also giving young full kippa. From there, one sampradaya started, you know, from Nimbarka Vansa. His origin is there. From Chatusan, his origin Lakshi. And this way, you know, parampara going on. So, Vishnu Swami, you meet Vishnu Swami, after that Rudradeep, you can worship, give water to Shivji Maharaj, pray for Kripa. From there, you can cross and come on and on, you can come. Then you can, last, you can meet with Bharadraj Trila, Bharadraj Rishi. Bharadraj Rishi was a big, you know, Rishi, powerful Rishi. He was doing bhajan there, where is at present Bharadra, Tila means hips. He used to do bhajan there long time, then Gauranga bless him. Blessing him, fully. There. So, I think, I forget actually, I can remember. So, then he blessed him, that you can take birth at Ballavacharya. I think so. If not wrong, I can rectify tomorrow if I am wrong. I cannot remember. I think so. He bless, Gauranga bless you. You can again take birth at Ballavacharya and you can meet with me in Puri. I can give you again kiva. This way actually, yes, you know, this I think so, but I forget. Bharadraj, you see, this spot. And near Bharadraj Chila, you will have to go towards, at present the track, towards Belpukuri, you will have to go, little distance. Then left side, you can get the spot of Jayadev Goswami. Now only a bamboo structure, bamboo, you know, garden. You cannot find anything. You know, where is Maharaj, I cannot see. Yes, but that is a special spot where Jayadev Goswami used to stay there, do bhajan, and wrote, Pralaya paya didyale dhito banasi vedam bhita bahita charitra khamakhedam keshava dhita mina sarira jai jagadis hare jai jagadis hare. This here he wrote. That's right. So you can see, from there we have to again come cross this, that place. Then again you have to come to Jagapitsi Mandir to stop your parikram. That is all. Jagapit Mandir. You see, this is the rules. You will have to do parikram. So very nice actually, all, you know. So now yesterday I was discussing that which dip is, you know, which dip is what? Where which, you know, this Antardip is Atmanivedan Khetva, first point. I told you yesterday. Sri Vishnu Sravane Parikshit Abhavad Vayasaki Kirtane Pralhada Swarane Tadangri Bhajane Lakshmi Prithu Archane Taito Prithu Pujane Pujan means Archan After that what I told? Then akurrastu avivandane kapipadira dasse atho sakhya arjuna sarvasva nivenane bali rabhud resha bhakti tapti param. That is the excellent way of getting prema, devotion, bhakti. So now you know everything, it is clear there. Who Acharya is what practicing? What? First you find Shukadev Goswami, Sravan first. This one darshan is there, tomorrow I can discuss. If at all Sravan is not there, then Kirtan is not possible. Though I can prove tomorrow the Sravan, Kirtan and Smaran simultaneously. I can prove tomorrow. Very important point tomorrow. So, actually, point is that we see Parikshit Maharaj hearing. Parikshit Maharaj hearing because Shukadev Goswami is singing. So, Sravan Acharya, Parikshit Maharaj. Kirtan Acharya, Shukadev Goswami. Smaran Acharya, who? Prahlad, you see, and you see deep, this Antardip, and Kirtanakhardip I already go through, and Simantardip I already told, Sravan, and Smaran, this is, you know, I told you Naimish Chhatra, Madhyadvip. Remember, everything you have to remember. If you forget, there is vast, you know, Siddhanta, I cannot repeat this point. Very, you will have to memorize. Remember. So you see. So that's you know, that's what is, you see. So Swaran Bhakti is Swaran Bhakti, Prahlad Maharaj. Swaran Bhakti where? Madhyadvip, I already told. Now another point, Lakshmi Padasevanam. Padasevanam? Lakshmi Tadangri. Tadangri Sevane Lakshi. Angri mean Padasam, same thing. Angri mean Sanskrit. Padasaman, Pada also Sanskrit word, no problem. So that is Koladwip. That's why Siddhar Goswami Maharaj is very clever. He took shelter of, you know, Koladwip, very clever. So Koladwip is a Padasavanam Khetra. And now actually Padasavanam Khetra. After Padasavanam, Archan Khetra Ritu Deep. Archan Khetra Ritu Deep. Then after that, Archan Khetra Ritu Deep. After ki, across to Abhivandane. Abhivandane, Jannu Deep. Across to Abhivandane, Kapipadir Dase. Madhyadvip. Dasse. Kopipati Hanumanji. Madhyadvip. He used to serve the lotus feet of Ramchandra. That Teta Yuga, you cannot remember. That's why I told Madhyadvip is very important. Kopipati Dasse Atha Sakya Arjuna. That Sakya place is Rudradvip. So I distribute everything. You can remember? No, you can forget every fraction of second. I speak everything. All clear of deep and different acharya, how appear, how they are deserving still today, how you can take advantage of that. So I speak everything. Now if you have any question, you can put in front of me. If you have any question, Maharaj?
Madhyadvip starts exactly where?
Madhyadvip actually, if you go to Harihar Khetra, at present, no place. You will have to cross and go. Otherwise, you have to go big, you know, cross, you know. One stream of Alakaland you can find, you know. That place is Naimish Chhetra. Naimish Chhetra. Naimisharanya.
If you start from Gauranga Setu.
No, Gauranga Setu need not go. Why you are going to? I told you from Nishingapalli. I mean at the time in Itananda, doing at present we are doing just opposite. First we go to Surabhikunja, Godru, Sanandasu, then we go. But that time Nithananda doing crossing river, and then going up to Subarnavihar, Nishingapalli, Panchanantara, Nishingapalli, then come to Harihar Khetra. From Harihar Khetra you can speak that side. That is called Madhyadvip. That Madhyadvip is very important, you know. There actually. So you see this way how different forests are there. Who all are the acharyas of doing practicing acharyas there, Padasevanam, this there already. You know, this way. So if you have any question or any doubt you can put. Any question? No? No question because I am giving answer to everything. So you can. Masaji? No, actually, that is different thing. But actually, I told you, Bhaktivinoda Thakur installed Gaur Gadadhar. That picture is there with me. I can show you. That picture was taken forcefully by the. Forcefully taken. After that, Prabhupada installed Gaur Gadadhar. So when Prabhupada installed, we should believe that Gaur Gadadhar is there. No question. And. Yogapit Mandir, actually original picture is there with me. I can show you. Now at present I cannot speak. Actually, I heard my Guru Maharaj also at the time of Brahmacharya, when Guru Maharaj was Pranamananda Brahmachari, he used to worship, Prabhupada giving seva, writing and also worshipping. So if at all there is any such incident, Guru Maharaj could speak me, but I never heard. Only I heard this saying that Radha Madhav Vigraha, this history I can speak. Radha Madhav Vigraha, actually, one Brahmin, very pure Brahmin, I mean Vaishnava, he wanted to take darshan of different pilgrimage. Then he is crying, nobody to take care of his Radha Madhav Vigraha. Then he approached Bhagavati Devi, the mother of most merciful. Mother, can you take care of my deity so that I can, for some time, I can go and take darshan of Vrindavan, Gaya, Varanasi, I can go. Mother melted. So, well, I can take. She took, Radha Mother. Then somehow, puja started. Because the mother took responsibility in Jogpit. Mother used to stay there backside. Mother took me in, originally worshipping going on. Mother take darshan very with love, prema. And first of all, I heard Gaur Vishnupriya Vigraha was there. After that, Lakshmipriya Vigraha installed after. Panchatatta, everything. Originally, Gaur Vishnupriya, that picture is there with me. I can show you. Original picture. But I never heard this kind of story. My Guru Maharaj is supposed to tell me, but never told me. Anyway, but I can say this much, Radha Madhav Vigraha, when that Brahman, for at least 2, 4, 5 years, because that time there is no facility, he went at least maybe 2 years, I cannot remember. He came back and he wanted to take back his Radha Madhav so that he can start worshipping. But Bhagavati Ma started crying. I cannot give this Vigraha because I love this Vigraha. So Brahman was bound to give back. Bhagavati Ma cannot give. She is crying and crying, rolling down. When Brahman going to take, Brahman then told, okay, you love my Radha Madhav so much, so Radha Madhav is yours. Krishna say, Tomar Krishna dite paro. Who can? Who is loving Krishna? Krishna can go to him. Who have no loving relation with Krishna, Krishna cannot go. It is written there in Chaitanya Jyotir. Regarding Krishna Bhajan, one thing is necessary. There is strong attraction, love. Krishna Bhajan, no caste and creed, irrespective of any caste and creed, you can do Krishna Bhajan, you have right. But provided you are loving Krishna, because Guhak Chandal, strong loving relation with Ramchandra. Guhak Chandal, you heard from Ramayana. Then you can do, you, provided you have, Hanumanji speaking, I am actually, you know, beast, I am Pashu. How Lakshmana Graja can develop, I can develop this kind of prema? I don't know. I can cut my chest and so, the Ram Lakshman, you are sitting there, Sita. Hanumanji is so strong. So this way you see, so Radha Madhav, Vigraha, till then, as installed in Jagpit. So previously, actually, Radha, Gaur Vishnupriya. After that, Panchatatta and this, that was established later, you see. Originally this. And one question, what question?
We always hear that in Navadvipa Dham, all offences are overlooked. It's a very merciful Dham.
Yes, that doesn't mean you can do commit aparadha over and again. I used like to hear then.
Whereas Vrindavan is very strict. Which offences are overlooked and which ones are committed here? What is the meant? What is
actually those who are sadhak, try to remember them. Listen to me very carefully. Those who are doing bhajan in sadhan, sadhan means you are practicing mood. Sadhan means practicing under the guidance of, strong guidance of Sadguru. Repeatedly, abhyas yog is only possible under the guidance of one proper Sadguru. Abhyas yog, practicing. So you are not practicing bhakti. You are trying to get bhakti. Follow. In this way, you are ignorant. Agyaneno avritam gyanam teno mujhyanti yantabha. You are bound to commit aparadha. You are doing harinam. Your mind going to Bombay. Your mind going to Calcutta. Doing aparadha. Unstability. You are going to take bath in Ganga. Spit. Aparadha, big aparadha. It is the rules to how you can take Ganga bath with new cloth. Those who are taking bath in new cloth, not with gamcha even, not with oil, not with soap, nothing. You can go to Ganga and pray prostrate to Ganga, Ganga Devi ki jai, pray dandavat and take it this way. First of all, you take sprinkle water, achaman. Padasparsa dosh, I am touching my leg to your water, please excuse mother, I am your child. Then go into water, stand and take, catch two of your, you know, ear and take bath. Two times, three times, then get up. Don't they rubbing leg, this, that, swimming. Ah, Maharaj Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, not for you. Any kind of aparadha you do for Ganga, taking bath, that's why, devotee and Gadadhar Pandit took Pundarik Vidyanidhi. He used to take darshan of Ganga night time, not in daytime. If you watch daytime, maybe some last dead body going, then aparadha. Whenever you are crossing any Brahmanadi, you know, nobody can speak this way. Try to remember to avoid aparadha. When you are going to Calcutta, crossing river by bus or launch, crossing river, you will, first of all, you have to pray to Ganga. Ganga, I am crossing you, please excuse me. Any Brahma river, any Brahmanadi, Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati, any Brahmanadi, when you are crossing by boat or launch or by bridge, you will have to pray for pardon. Nobody knows. All blind. Taking prasadam, dancing, nice doing bhajan. They don't know. This way you are committing aparadha. So this is the system to take bath in Ganga. Dhamma, in Dhamma also. In Dhamma also you are committing aparadha. You are thinking some material thing, committing some aparadha. You can imagine what kind of aparadha. I cannot speak all. It is not possible for me. You will have to think out. To do business in Dham, to insult any Vaishnava in Dham, into Vaishnava aparadha. And to Dham, into material idea, the Dham, what is that? Pass stool and urine anywhere you like, under tree. All trees there, all, you know, Dibya, Munirisi, those are sages in the form of trees there in Vrindavan and Navadvip. Be careful, man. So you can do any aparadha here, any time. So this kind of Dham aparadha, Nam aparadha, Vaishnava aparadha, you know, you have to avoid. You can, if you can, somehow Dham going to give you kripa. But not that, you know, you can do anything and it's not good. Like I can see, you know, Chapal Gopal doing aparadha. Somehow it was excused. Jagai Mata doing aparadha. Somehow Nityananda Babu excuse, Gauranga excuse. There you see, you know, Devananda Pandit committing aparadha, somehow excuse. So this way, knowingly or unknowingly, you are doing a common aparadha, it's okay. If you are doing big aparadha like Kalapahar. Kalapahar, you know, destroying all deities. Previously he was Brahman, after that leave and joined Muslim people, and more than Muslim people. They started breaking our Hindu temple. So you cannot act like that. You must be very careful and do Sankirtan. Gaur Nithai, Gaur Nithai. Submission mood should be there. And demonic mood is there, if the, how you can get demonic mood. That kind of mood is should not be there. I mean, at least humbleness should be there. Somehow you commit aparadha. Regarding archan, rewarding cooking, should be very careful. My word is evolution for all everybody. I know, but still I am bound to speak. You are cooking inside kitchen. You are going to offer this, you know, item to Krishna. So you have to be very careful, like Jagannath temple. You cannot, you know, do anything you like inside temple. Inside kitchen is also temple. In kitchen, somebody cooking who is full of kama and krodha, he should not touch. At least pure. At least who is not committing any aparadha. Somehow some aparadha done is okay. Somehow that can be excused. Who is doing harinam at 1 lakh? Otherwise, I cannot allow anybody to enter kitchen. It was the system in my mot. There was great evolution with me. All foreign devotees. No Mataji can speak with any brahmachari. If I speak, hey! They can fly. I cannot allow. Without any reason. So strong. You see. So this way, we cannot, and even when kitchen cooking going on, even you have no right to get the smell. If you are greedy, you are cooking. Today chana rasa going on sweet ball and paramanna, then Krishna cannot take. Because already your sight is there. You are putting your sight. Jagannath is less interested. So at least pure devotees should cook. You cannot allow any Matajis, anybody else, touch salgram and go doing anything you like. Parampara Siddhar Goswami Maharaj is giving strict instruction. Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, giving strict instruction. Inside mandir, inside kitchen, nobody can enter. Only some pure devotee. Only doing 1 lakh harinam. Where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Purushottam Dham already told, I can only accept prasadam in the hand of those lakhpati. Lakhpati, you know, who is doing harinam 1 lakh at least. So without purification you don't. But anyway, this is Gaur Dham. So somehow you can, some aparadha you are doing can be excused. Gaur Nithyananda merciful. That doesn't mean you can, knowingly you can do everything, all aparadha. That doesn't mean. Knowingly, you know it is aparadha. I should not allow that man inside. Because come on, I told you, Goshti Bhajan mean, if anybody doing aparadha, for that you are also going to get result. If archan, some foolish people doing archan inside temple, committing aparadha, he is aparadhi. Doing woman association like that with many things happens. If he is doing archan, then Krishna going to crush you. You see, that's why Prabhupada repeatedly told those who are common devotee at least pure. They are entering temple doing archan of Radha Govinda. At least they are not doing archan of Radha Govinda. It is the archan of Lakshmi Narayan. At the time of Prabhupada, Prabhupada doing bhajan night time in, Sankirtan Bhavan, front. There. And morning time, before Aruti, Prabhupada like, madman, running. Why? Everybody afraid. Why Prabhupada running? Prabhupada coming to temple and climb, upstairs. Some two or three staircase. Entering to temple, and under the leg of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, he is getting some letter, love letter. Catching, and come out, and Pujari, I say out! Out! Now, and forever, throw you out. Because Gauranga already speaking, he is doing Harina, Gauranga speaking. This is the nonsense he is doing, this Pujari. Who giving information? Doing Harinam, before Aruti Prabhupada run inside table, like ekdom mad. And under the leg of Gaur, getting so many love letters and come out and throw. See, this kind of offense never can be, So purposely you don't try to do it. Yeah? Somehow, knowingly you have no power, you see, somehow you are doing, that can be excused. But attitude should be very perfect. Demonic attitudes there, you can say, I can get up. No. Aparadha can be, In Dham, Vrindavan Dham, Radharani not at all ready to go into any kind of compromise for his Prananath Seva. Nandanandan Krishna is my Prananath. I cannot allow any kind of nonsense. But Gaur Dham, actually, Gaur Nityananda can bless you. But that doesn't mean you can commit aparadha over and again, purposely. That is not meant. Be careful. So now, somehow you are just, absent-minded for a little bit. This is also nam aparadha. While you are doing nam, your asana, your dress, your asana should be very pure. Mind, everything. Those who are Vaishnav, when they are sleeping, still they are pure. Those who are pure Vaishnav, they are sleeping there, that's where they are sleeping, they can start worshipping. Their bed is so pure. That doesn't mean your bed is also pure. You have to take care, be careful. Because they are sleeping whole, they can thinking about Krishna. When they are sleeping also, they are thinking about Krishna. Their purity can only be maintained through Krishna Smaran. Sriti,